La vitrectomia
The minimally invasive vitrectomy represents the most advanced frontier of what can be done inside the eye. Thanks to the miniaturization of technologies, it allows the elimination of pathologies that have caused problems at the retinal level and at vitreous level, such as hemorrhages, membranes that have grown on the retina in the cases of diabetic retinopathies and posterior vitreous detachment, but also all the diseases of the rhegmatogenous type, all the problems that afflict the vitreous and the retina when the vitreous is detached from it, and on the lesions are precisely called rhegmatogene. It can cause retinal detachment, which is a very debilitating disease that certainly leads to blindness if not treated. It can be prevented with extensive eye examinations by retinal specialists. It can be avoided by prophylactic laser treatment of the lesions. And above all, it must be treated with surgery, such as cerclage and or vitrectomy, in case the retina has already detached.
The minimally invasive vitrectomy has 27 gauge and now available on the market for 2 years. It allows a rapid restoration of the eye's functions and therefore a very quick patient's rehabilitation. This translates into a few hours hospitalization, and the patient can be discharged a few hours after surgery and can go home with a blindfold. The next day, the patient goes back to have it checked by the ophthalmologist. The eye is blindfolded until the patient is in a condition to resume normal activities. For intense activities such as gym or sport, usually the patient is laid off for at least 2 or 3 weeks. The minimally invasive 25 or 27 gauge vitrectomy allows the elimination of the vitreous, the gel that fills the eye, which is the basis of numerous pathologies of the vitreoretinal interface. When we are born, the vitreous is in a continuity with the retina, and therefore there is no separation between these two structures. When the vitreous begins to degenerate due to advanced age, myopia, trauma, or any other ocular diseases that can create inflammation inside the cavity itself, either the detachment of the vitreous or its degeneration leads to alterations of the space that is created between the vitreous and the retina. After birth, when we are children, this space is virtual. However, when we are adults, when the vitreous is detached, it is the pabulum for the growth of membranes, possibly pathologies of the vitreoretinal interface. These membranes begin to pull on the surface of the retina and distort it. The patient sees it distorted and fogged until it can lose the central vision by traction directly on the fovea, which is the most central point of the macula itself. Following this hole formation, the macular hole has an acute or minor loss of central vision, and the only way to treat this type of disease is minimally invasive vitrectomy. It allows a restoration of the retinal anatomy and the relaxation of the tractions that caused the macular hole itself. At the end of the intervention, the patient is introduced to a gas bubble that replaces the vitreous. This gas bubble has 2 functions. One is to plug the hole that is putting the patient in a vulnerable position for a few days, after which the gas has a great advantage of being reabsorbed. And 2, the body exchanges a secondary aqueous humor with a gas bubble. Therefore, the gas no longer needs further surgery to be removed, and this is very convenient because in a single operation, the tractions on the macula are all eliminated and the content of the eye is replaced with a gas that is slowly reabsorbed. In a unique treatment, all this allows to solve the problem.